ओके, सो नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज सिंगुलर पॉइंट. सो इट इज द पॉइंट एट विच द कॉम्प्लेक्स फंक्शन एफ ऑफ जेड इज नॉट एनालिटिक. द फंक्शन इज नॉट एनालिटिक, देन दैट पॉइंट इज कॉल्ड एज द सिंगुलर पॉइंट. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, एफ ऑफ जेड इज जेड माइनस टू अपॉन जेड माइनस वन जेड माइनस थ्री. सो इफ आई सब्स्टिट्यूट हियर जेड इक्वल टू वन, दिस इज नॉट डिफाइंड, दैट मीन्स नॉट एनालिटिक. इफ आई सब्स्टिट्यूट जेड इक्वल टू थ्री, इट इज नॉट डिफाइंड, दैट मीन्स नॉट एनालिटिक. सो हियर जेड इक्वल टू वन एंड जेड इक्वल टू थ्री आर सिंगुलर पॉइंट्स. वन मोर एग्जाम्पल, लाइक एफ ऑफ जेड इक्वल टू जेड स्क्वायर प्लस वन डिवाइडेड बाय जेड स्क्वायर प्लस फोर. सो वॉट आर द सिंगुलर पॉइंट्स? वॉट आर सिंगुलर पॉइंट्स? So only thing you have to do is that find out the factors. So z square plus 4 has factor z equal to plus minus 2i. So if I put z equal to 2i, this function is not defined, that means not analytic. If I put z equal to minus 2i, this function is not defined, that means not analytic. Z equal to plus 2i and z equal to minus 2i are singular points. This is very simple concept of singular points. The point at which the function is not analytic is called as singular point. Okay, so now next point is, you know the Euler identity. So according to Euler identity, e raised to power I theta is nothing but cos theta plus I sin theta. This is nothing but Euler identity. So based on Euler identity, you can have some MCQs. So first MCQ can be, what is value of minus 1? And there are four options. First option, e raised to power I pi by 2, e raised to power minus I pi by 2. Third option, e raised to power I pi. Last option, e raised to power minus I pi. These are the four options. So let's check one by one from options. First option is e raised to power I pi by 2. So e raised to power I pi by 2, use Euler identity. So it becomes cos pi by 2 plus I sin pi by 2. Cos pi by 2 is 0. Sin pi by 2 is 1. So it becomes I. So it is not the answer. Then e raised to power minus I pi by 2. It becomes cos pi by 2 minus I sin pi by 2. Cos pi by 2 is 0, sin pi by 2 is 1. So it becomes 0 minus I, that means minus I. Third option, e raised to power I pi. So that is nothing but cos pi plus I sin pi. So cos pi is minus 1, sin pi is 0. So minus 1 plus 0, that means minus 1. So we got the answer as e raised to power I pi. Again, this will be, this is also the answer, because e raised to power minus I pi is cos pi minus I sin pi. That becomes minus 1. So this is also the answer, e raised to power minus I pi. So there are two answers correct for this question. Next question, let us say, what is value of I raised to I? What is value of I raised to I? So just now we have determined that e raised to power I pi by 2 is nothing but I. So substitute here, so it becomes e raised to power I pi by 2 raised to power I, and use law of indices. E raised to m raised to n is, here I will write e raised to m raised to power n is nothing but e raised to m into n. So use here. So it becomes e raised to power I pi by 2 into I, that becomes e raised to power I square into pi by 2, so that becomes e raised to power minus pi by 2. So I raised to I has a value e raised to power minus pi by 2. So based on the Euler identity, you can have some MCQs. Okay, so next point is, you know that your f of z, it is nothing but u plus ib, where u is the real part and v is the imaginary part of this analytic function f of z. Suppose if I provide you u, if u is given to you and you have to determine f of z, or v is given to you, imaginary part is given to you and you have to determine f of z. So procedure is that we know that f of z is u plus ib. So differentiate this equation with respect to x. So this becomes f dash z equal to ux plus ivx. Then here use Cauchy-Riemann equation. So according to Cauchy-Riemann equation, vx is nothing but minus uy. So substitute here. So f dash z equal to ux minus I u y, and u is provided to you, right? So you can partial derivative with respect to x, you can find out partial derivative with respect to y. So you can have ux, you can have u y. So you can substitute here in f dash z. Okay, after that we have to make one substitution. Put x equal to z and y equal to 0. Wherever you will see x, there you have to put z. Wherever you will see y, you have to put 0. So now in f dash z, very few terms will be remaining. After that, what you have to do? You have to integrate with respect to z. So you will get f of z. So this is the procedure. Once again, quickly I will repeat. The point is that either u will be given, find out f of z, or other variety of question is v will be given, imaginary part will be given, find out f of z. So we know that f of z is u plus iv, differentiate f dash z equal to ux plus ivx. Here you have to use the Cauchy-Riemann equation. Suppose u is given, then we will substitute for vx. Suppose if v is given, we will substitute for ux. V is given, then we will substitute for ux by using Cauchy-Riemann equation. I will just write Cauchy-Riemann equations. Ux equal to vy, uy equal to minus vx. These are the Cauchy-Riemann equations. CR equations. So we have to take help of CR equations. Okay, so now u is given to you, so you can easily find out ux, you can easily find out uy, you can easily find out ux, you can easily find out uy. So substitute here. After that, make one more substitution, x equal to z and y equal to 0. And after that, integrate with respect to z, you will get f of z. It will be more clear by example. Let us start with the example. Suppose real part is x square minus y square. Find analytic function f of z. Okay, so we know that f of z is u plus iv, f dash z is ux plus ivx. I have differentiated with respect to x. Then use Cauchy-Riemann equation. So vx is nothing but minus uy. So f dash z equal to ux minus I u y. Okay. Now, what is u given in the question? X square minus y square. Now, use this fact given in the question, u equal to x square minus y square. So, partial derivative u x will be 2x, u y will be minus 2y. Partial derivative. Okay. Substitute this thing here. So, f dash z equal to 2x minus I times 2y. Now put x equal to z and y equal to 0. So f dash z equal to 2z minus 0, that means 2z. Now integrate with respect to z. Integrate with respect to z. So f of z will be integration 2z dz, that is nothing but z square by 2 to cancel plus c. So this is our analytic function f of z. Now let us see one more example. Imaginary part is b equal to three x square y minus y cube. Find analytic function f of z. Find analytic function f of z. Okay. So v is given 3x square y minus y cube. So as soon as v is given, you should find out vx, vy. So vx will be 6xy. And vy will be 3x square minus 3y square. Okay. F of z is nothing but u plus iv. We know this thing. Then differentiate with respect to x. So f dash z will be ux plus ivx. Okay. Vx, vy are available. So use Cauchy-Riemann equation to replace this ux. So according to Cauchy-Riemann equation, ux equal to vy by CR equation. This is the by Cauchy-Riemann equation. Substitute here. So it becomes vy plus I vx. So this is my f dash z. Substitute the value of vy, vx. We have already found. Substitute here. So vy is nothing but 3x square minus 3y square. Vx is 6xy plus I times 6xy. Now put x equal to z and y equal to 0. So f dash z will be 3z square minus 0 plus 6x into 0, that means 0. So that is simply 3z square. So this is my f dash z. Now integrate with respect to z. So f of z equal to 3 z cube by 3 plus c, that means z cube. So this is my f of z. Okay. So this is the procedure to determine f of z when real part is given or imaginary part is given. So this is how you can find out f of z by either real part is given or imaginary part is given. Now next is, suppose your u is x square minus y square plus xy, and you have to determine imaginary part of analytic function f of z. and these are the four options. So don't follow the lengthy procedure. Instead, use shortcut method, because here options are available. So use some trick to get the answer. Okay, so U is given and we have to determine V, and four options are given. Okay, so what will be the shortcut? So use CR equation. So according to CR equation, Ux equal to Vy and Vx equal to minus Uy. These are the Cauchy-Riemann equation. So use this equation to get answer in short amount of time. Okay, so U is given. Just find out Ux. So that becomes 2x plus y. This is equation 1. Now Ux equal to Vy. And V, for V, we have four options available. So for every option, differentiate with respect to y, partial derivative with respect to y, and check which option will give you 2x plus y. Okay, so for first option, what is Vy for first option? Option number 1. What is Vy? It is nothing but x plus 2y. Okay, option is not matching. I want 2x plus y. Second option, B option number B. So option B is 2xy plus 2y square minus x square. So what will be Vy then? So 2xy, partial derivative with respect to y. 2xy ka partial derivative with respect to y. So it becomes 2x plus partial derivative of 2y square minus x square. So it becomes 4y. So again, this option is not matching. Now check for option C. Option C is 2xy plus 1 by 2xy square minus x square. So partial derivative. So 2xy partial derivative, 2x, then plus 1 by 2 is a constant, partial derivative of y square minus x square with respect to y. So that becomes 2y minus 0. So 2 cancel. So it is giving me 2x plus y. So it is satisfying my option, right? So this option is satisfying. Now let's check option D also. So xy, so partial derivative with respect to y, that means x plus 1 by 2 times 2y, 2 cancel, that means x plus y. So again, it is not satisfying, 2x plus y. So only option C is satisfying. Only option C is satisfying. Option C, ux is 2x plus y. Here, vy is 2x plus y. Option C, according to option C, ux equal to vy. That means Cauchy-Riemann equation is satisfied for option C. Cauchy equation satisfied by option C. So my correct answer is option C. So this is how you can go by the option whenever real part is given and you have to determine imaginary part. One more question. Let us say u is 2x 1 minus y. Find imaginary part v of analytic function, and four options are available. Okay, so u is given. So what will be ux? So 2 1 minus y. Partial derivative with respect to x. So 2 1 minus y. Okay, this is equation number 1. Now let's go by the option. Okay, first option. What is v in the first option? X square plus y minus 1 whole square. So partial derivative with respect to y. So it will be 2x, sorry, it will be 2 times y minus 1 square is there. So derivative is 2y minus 1. So it is not satisfying, because we want 2 1 minus y. It is giving me 2 y minus 1. So this option A is not satisfying. Now check option B. So according to option B, x square minus y minus 1 whole square. So what is Vy for option B? That will be minus 2 times y minus 1. So it can be written as 2 times 1 minus y. So this option is satisfying. Vy equal to ux. Okay, now let's check option C. So partial derivative with respect to y will be और ऑप्शन सी पार्शियल डेरिवेटिव विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू वाई विल बी यू वाई वी वाई इक्वल टू 2y. So again it is not satisfying. 2 1 minus y, it is not giving me 2 1 minus y. So c is not the correct answer. Now check option d. So differentiate with respect to y, so it is giving me minus 2y. Vy equal to minus 2y. So again for only option b, ux equal to vy, for only option b, ux equal to vy, that means it is satisfying. Only option b is satisfying CR equation. So b is the correct answer. So here correct answer is option